Get on up.
Everybody right there.
Get into it.
Everybody right there.
Get involved.
Everybody, you. Come on. Come on. Come on.
From the perspective of the individual who's using transit, it's healthier. A person has to walk from home to the bus or rail stop and from the stop that they get off at to their destination. It also saves money, and according to the APTA, which is the national sponsor of this event, on average a two-person household can save more than $10,000 a year by downsizing to one car, and that would be more than $800 a month.
Well, our highest priority has been for many years now the airport corridor. It's an existing right-of-way. Would connect to the airport, connect our airport to our central city. We also have a stop at the Galleria Mall and a park and ride out at Transit Road. It was part of the original plan for the light rail. It's a publicly owned right-of-way, so it would be relatively inexpensive to build there, and we see that as the highest priority. Out to the Amherst campus is another high priority, and that's one that the NFC is starting to work on. There's a study going on right now looking at alternatives for taking efficient transit, either light rail or bus rapid transit or some other transit mechanism out to that Amherst campus. Well, go ahead, you want in?
The east side is a disadvantaged neighborhood, and the route that we are advocating to the airport goes out Broadway through a neighborhood where there's a lot of potential for economic development. And what we're seeing around the country is that when transit goes in, developers come in. It's referred to as transit-oriented development. People put in mixed-use housing, they put in retail. I meant mixed-income housing is what I meant to say. And the latest trend with transit-oriented development is to make sure that it's done equitably so that it doesn't displace low-income people but provides options for them to stay where they are in a more enhanced neighborhood.
It's also mixed-use development as well. So it's not all single-family and it's not all residential. It mixes residential with business, which is the new trend. And we're very pleased that the new Buffalo Green Code allows for that. So the east side is a great opportunity to start to actually see some benefits from that. Well, there's a lot we can do because it's a sort of a difficult system to use. We could do everything from a bus rapid transit system where we put out some dedicated lanes for the buses away from other traffic, to queue jumping systems where they allow the buses to get around queues and stoplights. We can have the bus driver be able to control the street lights. When they get there, they can get a green light for the bus. We can improve our stations. Right now, the stations, many of them are not that comfortable. We can have off-bus payment systems, which speeds the entry onto the bus system. You don't have to file past the bus driver. You pay for your ticket before the bus comes. So when the bus comes, you just get on and it's much more efficient. Lots of things these are all things that are happening all over the country right now. So we need to be on board with it as well.
The website is www.citizenstransit.org. On Facebook, we are Citizens for Regional Transit. And the phone number is
716-691-8528.